हेलो एवरीवन, विद फॉस्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द पोएम चाइल्डहुड ऑफ ग्रेड 11 बाय मार्कस नेटन। द पोएट इज़ ऑब्सेस्ड विद द लॉस ऑफ हिज चाइल्डहुड। लॉस ऑफ चाइल्डहुड एंड स्टेपिंग इनटू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ अडल्ट्स वाज अ ग्रेजुअल प्रोसेस। द पोएम डिस्क्राइब्स द ग्रोथ ऑफ इंडिविजुअलिटी, रैशनैलिटी एंड द एबिलिटी टू सी थ्रू द हिपोक्रेसी ऑफ द ग्रोन अप्स। दे वर द ग्रेजुअल स्टेप्स that led to the loss of childhood and its importance, and we will discuss about this in this poem. A brief introduction about the poet. Marcus Netten was a Norwegian poet. Details of his life is very sketchy, so it's unclear when and where he was born. He wrote this poem Childhood at the age of 12. The poem is a translation, and one can imagine how great it would be in his language at this age. Okay, I am giving the introduction of the poem. Childhood is written by Marcus Netten. In this poem, the poet thinks over his lost childhood. He wonders about the moment where he lost the innocence and realized that the world is not what he seemed it to be. He recalled when his thoughts changed and he realized the hypocrisy of the people around him. He finally settled down to the idea that his childhood went to some forgotten place and is hidden in the face of an innocent infant. Now, starting with the explanation of the poem, stanza 1, it says, "When did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography and therefore could not be? Was that the day?" The explanation part goes like this. The poet is obsessed with the loss of his childhood. He wants to know exactly when he lost his childhood, and he makes different calculations. He realizes that the process of attaining adulthood and the loss of childhood is gradual. It involves different stages of growth. The poet makes a guess that it was at the age of 11 when he started thinking like a rational human being. He realized that hell and heaven were mere imaginary concepts and they existed only in the mind. It was the time when he started differentiating between truth and imagination, reality and fiction. Stanza 2 says, "When did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not all they seemed to be? They talked of love and preached of love, but did not act so lovingly. Was that the day?" Perhaps now the poet lost his childhood when he was able to see through the hypocrisy of the adults. He realized that the grown-ups were not as good as they appeared to be, nor did they practice love in their life as they frequently talked and preached. Gradually, when he learned this art, he moved a step forward towards adulthood. Stanza 3 says, "When did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine, to use whichever way I chose, producing thoughts that were not those of other people, but my own and mine alone? Was that the day?" Now the poet came to a stage when he developed the art of independent thinking, and at this stage he realized that his mind was his own and it was not influenced or directed by others. And this is the day when he developed his independent thinking and he ceased to be a child. Here he talks about that he has his own mind and thoughts and which were not bound by anyone's. And that was the time he realized that he lost his childhood. Stanza 4 says, "Where did my childhood go? It went to some forgotten place that is hidden in an infant's face. That is all I know." In the last stanza, the poet asks, "Where did my childhood go?" Then he comes out with an answer. Perhaps his childhood is lying hidden at a place that has been forgotten. The glimpse of his lost childhood can be seen over the innocent face of an infant. Now the poet only has his sweet memories of his childhood that would soon fade away. He also conveyed a message that the innocence of childhood stays till the time one is an infant, and that is all he knows. Now talking about the summary of the poem, childhood is from the poet Marcus Netten. In the childhood poem, the poet discussed the loss of his childhood. The poet talks about that the very moment where his innocence was lost. He talks about the various instances when he could have lost his childhood. Furthermore, a realization comes to the poet that the world is not what it seems. He recalls when a change in his thoughts took place. The poet believes that the people around him are hypocrites. It seems that the poet will never be able to trust people around him ever again. This is because he is aware of their hypocrisy. The poet believes that adults preach love, but their actions don't reflect that. The author tells us that his childhood went to some forgotten place. Moreover, the poet explains that his childhood is hidden in the face of an infant who is innocent. The message or the central idea we get from the poem is, the poem Childhood focuses on the theme of the loss of innocence. Marcus Netten, the poet, wonders when and where he lost his childhood. He ponders over this question and highlights the loss of innocence and faith in the quest of growing up and becomes aware of the realities of life. Now talking about the poetic devices used in the poem. First is the rhyming scheme. Students, we know what the rhyming scheme is. And the rhyming scheme which is used in the poem Childhood is ABBCCD. The next is refrain, that is a group of phrase which is repeated in the poem just to give a rhythmic sense to it. And that what was repeated is, when did my childhood go? Was that the day? The next is oxymoron, where two opposite words are used together in a sentence is in the poem is hell and heaven, that are two opposite words but used together. Hell and heaven cannot be together ever, but they are used in the poem just to give a oxymoron in the poem. The next is the alliteration. As we know, the occurrence of the same letter of sound at the beginning of the close connected words is alliteration, the first alphabet. Example is the time, the T sound is repeated, my mind, M sound is repeated, that is the consonant sounds, whichever way, that W sound is repeated, and thoughts, that T sound is repeated. This is called alliteration. Now coming to the vocabulary which is used in the poem. It is already given in your book. You can read it carefully. Now, I hope students that you were able to understand the poem explanation and the poetic devices used in the poem. I hope you like the video, and if you like the video, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much. God bless you all.